Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I thought I would do a video with a quick diet tip that can help you if you're struggling to adopt a new diet and to get into it. I've done this a lot of times and I know that it can be a struggle, especially if you're trying to do something like a ketogenic diet. And so this advice is gonna apply no matter what kind of diet you're trying to do. If you're trying to do intermittent fasting, you're just trying to get on some kind of a diet program or routine or eating schedule, right? Or eating plan or something like that, meal plan. And this will help you to not be so overwhelmed. So I got this, I'm part of a group, a ketogenic group from the podcast, Two Keto Dudes. If you've seen the interview with Carl Franklin I did about ketogenic diets, that he runs this group and he has that podcast. Also, if you're interested in any of the fitness videos that I do, I've got a bunch of fitness and diet stuff, and not everyone is interested, but if you are, you can check them out here. I talk about all kinds of stuff, like why I eat one meal a day and all that. But what I want to talk about today is, you know, on the group, there was someone who had a problem, right? They expressed that they were getting frustrated because they didn't feel like, they felt hungry, they felt like they didn't know what they're doing, they couldn't cook all these complicated ketogenic meals, their fat levels weren't high enough, and they were struggling to like get the right macronutrient balance, and it seemed too hard, right? And I think this is a huge frustration for anyone trying to do any kind of new diet. And it doesn't have to be ketogenic. This could be like you're doing some kind of, you know, whatever, intermittent fasting diet, or maybe you've got some kind of meal program or something. You want to just get healthy and you've got an idea of what you want to do. And so my advice to you is basically this. Look, so what you want to do is you're just gonna tomorrow or today, when you got some time, you're gonna block out a couple hours and you're gonna spend those couple of hours planning. And what you're gonna plan out is you're gonna plan out day A of meals and day B, just day A and day B. And here's what you're gonna do. You're going to calculate, right, exactly what you're trying to hit. If you're trying to hit a certain calories or whatever your macronutrients are, and you're gonna plan out however many meals you're having, if you're having two meals or three meals or one meal like I do, right, it's fine, but you're gonna plan out those meals specifically so that you hit exactly the calorie counts that you want, and you're gonna plan out what recipes that you're gonna utilize in those meals, right, and you're just gonna plan out meal A, or day A and day B, okay, and that's it. And you're gonna take the time to do this and calculate that all. You're gonna sit down once to do this and then you're gonna have that done. And now you're gonna know what to do. Now, what you're gonna do next is for the next couple of weeks or so, you're just gonna eat, either you're gonna alternate day A or day B. So your shopping, your grocery shopping is gonna be simple because you're gonna buy the same groceries, right? It's either for day A meals or day B meals, right? You're going to learn how to cook those specific recipes and try to keep them simple at first. Do, you know, maybe one thing that's fairly complicated and then the rest all simple for the day, and you're going to learn, right? So during that 2 week time, you're going to be adapting to this new thing. You're not going to have to think about it. You're not going to have to calculate and say, oh, you know, run the numbers, because you know that if you follow this plan that you're going to be eating exactly what you need to eat, and then you're going to be learning. You're going to be learning how to shop. It'll become easy, right? It's going to start to become a habit. You're going to learn how to cook those meals. If you have specific recipes, you're not a good cook, and you're going to get good at it, and it's going to take a couple of weeks or so. And then what you can do is you can keep doing that if you want, or you can start to add a little bit more variation. Maybe you add day C now. Now you plan out day C and you add a little bit more variation. You add a new recipe, right? And you can keep on going. And maybe you add a day D. Maybe you have like four different days and that you alternate between, or you have like five or six different recipes. Or one other thing that you could do is you could eat your standard meals day on Monday through Friday, and on Saturday is when you experiment with a new meal in your diet. You know, let's say you're doing a ketogenic diet that you're going to try to cook and see if you're going to put it into your rotation, right? The key thing here is that what we're doing is we're simplifying. We're getting rid of the stress. We're getting rid of the decision-making process. We're making it so that you know what to eat, you know when, and you don't have to guess and you don't have to get frustrated. Because if every day you are counting calories and you're weighing decisions and you're trying to figure out, is your macronutrient ratio in balance? Are you getting enough fats? Are you getting too much fat? Whatever you're trying to accomplish, right? It's gonna be stressful every day. And when you go to the menu, you know, go out to eat and stuff, right? You're gonna have problems, right? So instead of doing that, instead of dealing with all that, relieve all the stress, just start off real simple, day A and day B. And then what will happen is eventually, let's say you're doing a ketogenic diet, for example, you would have a repertoire of recipes, right? But you'd have built a base. You would have had success with very simple day A and day B, and just like maybe one or two recipes that you had to learn how to cook, and you'd master that, and then you expand on that. So you're never doing something that's too hard for you and never feeling overwhelmed. Because a lot of times what happens is you feel overwhelmed, it's too hard, you're already doing all this stuff, maybe you start running and lifting weights and all this stuff, and so you quit. So that's my advice. I've applied this a lot of times, right? And I've because I felt the frustration. I've been there where I'm trying to do a new diet, trying to do a new program, and I don't have it figured out. And you could even like make it so that certain meals you eat out, right? Or that you've got an allotment, right? There's a lot of ways you can do this. The key thing is so that you plan this ahead of time, so you know what the plan is. And you can have different rules, and you can, but once you have these rules and once you have this plan, not only, like I said, is it going to take off the stress, but it's going to give you a framework for success. You're going to know that all I have to do is follow these rules and I'm going to be successful. If you have to make judgment calls all the time, I guarantee you, whatever the diet is, you will fail, because I suck at making judgment calls, right? That's why I make rules for myself. So I hope this helps you. If you're interested again in some of the other diet and fitness advice that I have, you can check out the other videos I've done on this. I know some of you like to hear about these things. It's a problem, you know, we all kind of struggle. We all have bodies, so we all need to worry about our health, right? So anyway, if you like this video, I've got a big favor to ask, which is, of course, if you haven't subscribed already, you know, hit the subscribe button. If you did, hit like, thumbs up, there you go. But if you didn't, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below, and I will talk to you next time. Take care.